Hello, viewers. I'm SB, and welcome back to the Curious Expedition. The music died. There it is. Okay. Let's get out there. Let's chalk up another victory. Whew. All right, I'm excited. I think we're actually going to end up with a pretty good score, even though we're intentionally not really focusing on score. Oh, you know what? I didn't need to sell that item I could have gifted because we were going to get 70 funds from this. All right. Find your missing husband and bring him home? No. Here's the thing about that. That dude's going to eat one of us. I really like my team at this point. I still might consider trading Shaburji Baba for Battle Cat. If the opportunity came up, I totally might. But that's the only change I would make. Okay, we don't need 15 colorful marbles, probably. But on the other hand, why would I not take 15 colorful marbles? Well, I guess the answer is we could just take nothing and upgrade this dude's pack again. Is that an option? Do I have that choice? Because we have, like, all the supplies in the world. We didn't use any of our whiskey last time. We are once again going to a place where there are two missions. Ah, you actually cannot get more than 3 extra capacity. Well, in that case, let's, I guess, just, like, buy all this. That seems fine. We'll bank 90 funds, is that? No, we should have torches, though. Yeah, deal. Set sail. I have totally forgotten what the purple mushrooms do. I do not remember at all. I'm sure we used them. I don't know. Maybe we can trade them to somebody. Let's refill water. I mean, we may as well do this. Begin. Okay, I see no question marks of any kind. This seems like a fine time to use some weather balloons. Well, that was not as helpful as I was hoping, I'll be honest with you. Okay. That's a lot of information. So we can see a huge mountain range here, and there's some kind of big chasm over there. But the way the map is shaped suggests to me that this whole top half can't be empty. I mean, I guess it can be. Totally can be, actually. But it shouldn't be. I would not like it if it was, so it shouldn't be. Ooh. I don't know that we can beat slavers in combat. I'm pretty sure we can't use the mule unless we're not overburdened. As long as we are overburdened, I don't think we can, is what I'm trying to express with words. And a big part of fighting the slavers is that they usually have weapons. That's one of the big reasons I like to do it. Yeah, let's not even get involved in that. So we go to this hill, see what's what. Okay, a lot of raptors, and I'm nervous about raptors at this point in the game. It's probably 3. So we can do something like this. This probably keeps us out of that raptor's path. Okay, that's got a little close. Don't you keep going north. Oh my god, he's chasing us. Okay. Wow, that raptor is really after us. Like, not even a little subtle. Alright, a German explorer's camp. Okay. I don't feel too bad about that. So hyenas, probably just 3 hyenas, maybe even 4. We can take hyenas, I'm not too worried about that. Ripper leap and punctuation are both instantly lethal. This could be the pyramid, maybe. You see that that conspicuous hexagon of same type spaces. If it is the pyramid, that's not awesome. Oh god, we veered south a little much. Okay. Because obviously it's currently being guarded. Well, that sucks. Shoot. Okay, I think we're gonna have to make camp. I think I would rather make camp than drink the whiskey, is basically what I'm saying. We're pretty safe. We can level up our nun. And then we'll have enough sanity that we won't be in the mostly bad events area. Or we could drink one whiskey. I'm gonna risk a single whiskey. Okay. Try to save leveling up the nun. Because her combat prowess doesn't really change. There's no hurry to do it. Hey, plus 10 fame. We discovered some constellations or something. I don't know. I don't read the text. Come on. Alright, one more rest ought to do it. Increased loyalty from Sir Bateman. He loves to be animal handled. Don't you come over here. Oh god, we're gonna have to fight these raptors. I'm trying so hard to avoid it. Yeah, I can't mount up. Alright, you want to wander away, not toward. Oh god. Oh, this sucks so much. If we could use the dynamite as a weapon, we'd be fine. But we can't. Alright, let's not forget that we do have the ability to teleport. Do I have to use it now? Maybe. If this is the Golden Pyramid, though, we won't be able to access it, right? Because it'll either be buried or it will be... it will require us to find some seals. But we could at least reveal the location of the seals. I was hoping to save the targeted teleportation scroll until the end of the game. Until the sixth expedition. But maybe we just use it now for safety. Because we are cornered. We are going to get attacked. Yeah. Alright, safety. Oh, it's just a traitor. Okay, let's see what's up. Ah, he's not showing us the good stuff, which is a shame. We can afford some good stuff right now. What do we want? Do I want anything? You want these mushrooms? I don't want to carry these things around anymore. I can't remember what they do, and I don't want to carry them around anymore, basically. Alright, these have good trade value at missions and... Or not at missions, but at villages, and I think that's really the only thing that's relevant. And we could get cans of food, which have good trade value at missions. It's a little safer for us. It does take up an extra inventory slot, though. The machetes stack neatly into a slot we already have open. Yeah, I'll go machetes. Deal. Alright, so still a lot of stuff yet to find, then. Here's the first mission. It doesn't really benefit us in any way. I mean, we stay, right? There's no point in not staying. But, like, there's nothing to put in the storage room. I don't think I want to get rid of any of the stuff I have. We could give him our weather balloons, because I don't think we'll be using them. At this point, we're far enough in and we have enough stuff revealed. Yeah. I don't think we'll be using these. Do you have anything cool? You don't. I mean, they never do. I don't know why I checked. I will rest once. This means I don't have to play the drums again, so we might be able to evade some more animals. Oh, giant scorpion. Ooh, I don't think we want to do that. I don't think we want to start a big sinkhole. Trying to get away from the scorpion. Alright, I think we might be okay. We get out into the open here and we'll have some sight lines. We have to be so careful where we walk. Alright, we're at 2 standing right now. So we can stay at this village and get 70 sanity back and go back to 127. I don't think we're going to bother to spend the level up points before doing it then. They have a stone idol, which we could steal, but we don't have to. Again, our score is fine. I don't think we're not going to risk it. We are going to take this, and actually we're going to take horn flutes. Horn flutes let you get wildlife off your trail, we're going to take these and use them for their actual intended purpose. Also, voodoo dolls? No, we don't really need the voodoo doll thing. It is remarkable how overpowered we are right now. We don't need almost anything. Wait, I'm doing this wrong. Remove one of those and put up something worth 5. I don't know that I need to be min-maxing for perfect value here. I don't remember if there's another village. You know what, let's just buy some standing. We're going to stay here. And I can't imagine we're actually going to use all these beads for something like actually good. So why don't we just go to 6 standing? Because that feels like an okay number to me. Rest here. We will not hug the sick child. We will not steal their idol. Okay. This probably is important. Could be a seal. Nothing. Alright, I think there's a pretty good chance that the pyramids around here somewhere. Just based on how far we are from the ship and everything, but I guess maybe not. So it's in the middle somewhere. We're doing a lot more wandering than we usually do. Oh, the raptors. Okay, can we do this in a way that doesn't take us through the mosquitoes? And also doesn't veer us into a Velociraptor or Utah Raptor pack. Okay, we have aggroed. An alligator. A crocodile? A crocodile. Possibly 2. Crocodiles are pretty scary. Ooh, 3 tusks. We attracted some hyenas. I wish there was some way to use the hyenas to scare off the crocodiles. Alright, we're just gonna horn flute this. I do not want to fight a crocodile. This puts him to sleep for a couple of days. This is why we brought it. We should cleanse our superstition for sure. And maybe we'll get lucky and he'll have some good scrolls too. Waterfall creation, chasm, water drain, drylands. Okay, no, he does not. What he does have is green mushrooms. Maybe we should take some green mushrooms. Alright, so we'll do this, and you can have some of my whiskey? Maybe? Some of my animal teeth? You want some animal teeth? Alright, cleanse. Do we need to cleanse him? Paranoid's not awesome. Yeah, you know what? I think we can afford to. Alright, so we'll take 2 cleanses now, and 2 to go. Okay. I'm not super happy about the fact that he didn't have any. Oh, yeah, I'm dumb. This is bad play. We should have whiskied up to full and then dealt with him. I'm going to do it now. Yeah, see, we cleansed her and now we're going to pay for her cleansing again. That's just bad. That's just bad optimization. I mean, it's fine. We have more than enough value to make up for it, but still bad play. Okay. Well, we have plenty of torches. Let's see what's going on in here. Oh, it's not that kind of place. Well, what the hell? Where's the damn pyramid? Now I wish I did have my weather balloons. This is not how things usually go anymore. I guess we'll rest. There's no good reason not to. And then we will grab some more water. I suppose. Okay, let's see what's over here. Probably nothing is my guess. Yeah, nothing. What about this away? I'm guessing also not like a whole lot. That could be the pyramid, maybe. I think this is probably not the pyramid. This might be that other mission. In fact, I would bet, given the positioning and everything, that that's the other mission. Alright. If we get raptored, we can just sleep him. Alright, if the mummy wants to fight us, we can fight it. Yeah, we should be fine here. Alright, we found our Ripper Leap. And then I think the only other thing we can do is tactical advantage. Alright, so he will bleed out at the beginning of the next turn, or at the end of this turn. But we also can just lay into him a little bit more. Could be that. We do have to use a shrine at some point, probably, like, because we don't have any moonstones and we haven't found any seals. Ooh, could be over here. Oh, I'm overburdened, right? let's not run while overburdened. I guess we can toss a machete. That seems fine. What the hell? I didn't pin that. Yeah, let's horn flute the raptor. Obviously, I'm not overjoyed about that. Yeah, we have to check in here. That's totally a place it could be. Do I want to use 2 whiskey to get above 30 sanity? Or whiskey plus upgrade? Let's do an upgrade, actually. And a whiskey. Okay. And then we can rest here without fear of horrible, horrible things happening to us. So this is probably a mission. This is going to be a large area of all one type of hex, which certainly suggests that it could be the location of the pyramid. And I can't believe I didn't notice it at the time. In fact, it is the location of the pyramid. Is it going to require moonstones from us? I think it is. 2 of them. Despite the fact that there are none of them in our inventory. So, this is a shrine, and maybe that's a shrine? That's what I'm thinking. We don't have any rope or climbing gear or anything. Ooh. Not great. Okay. I think trying to get through here without getting caught by either of the animals is going to be a fool's errand. Let's just go toward the hyenas. 4 hyenas. Okay, we can do this. Wow, maybe we can do this. This is a terrible roll. Oh, you know what we can do is, shoot, what is it? It's hand-eye mind? Okay, there. None of them get to attack. Now we can figure stuff out at our leisure. Leisure? At our leisure. So let's take this. We actually do still have the dice for Ripper Leap plus punctuation. Didn't quite get there. Okay, but that kills one of them and doesn't let them attack. Hand-eye mind. We'll just do it again. Yeah, it turns out we can fight an infinite number of... I don't want this. I want sword on that. Wow. Did we really not roll any attacks of any kind? Oh, no, we have kick. We do have a kick. Yeah, we can fight any number of hyenas, it turns out, because we... we'll basically always be able to pull this. Hyenas are easily tricked. Am I going to go, seriously, the entirety of this battle without rolling sword even once? I am. That is actually going to happen. Alright, well that one's dead. Oh my god, sword. Alright. Faint them, and then all 3 of these dice are the wrong face. Wow! And we rerolled all of them into the correct face. Okay, we don't need the meat. The meat is no value to us. We don't need probably all this water. This is kind of a lot of water. On the way back to the ship, it will be inconvenient to hit this. I guess, unless we're going to hit the pyramid and then want to go back to the ship from there. So we're going to have to go past this. Yeah, so we can refill at that time. So I think we can afford to toss this water now. Alright, we need to have more sanity than we have right now. Which means alcoholism, hooray. We're definitely going to take the long way around. We're going to hit this shrine and run past it. Oof, we don't have a lot of red dice. We're not good at climbing. Yeah, if this turns out to be a climbing shrine, we're in like really serious trouble. I used all my rope. We could go to the village and see if they have rope. Yeah, let's make that the plan. So, what are we looking at, sanity-wise, to go to this village? Without taking a mosquito-laden path. 48. Not even that much. Alright. Please, giant bird, do not walk in front of me. Okay. Oh, God. Alright. It's chasing us, though. Alright, tell me you guys have some rope. You do not have any rope. Crap. Nor anything really useful at all. Okay, we're just gonna have to, if it's a climbing shrine, we're just gonna have to get there. Really, the only thing that would be disastrous is if we lost our animal handler. So let's trade them all of this stuff. For standing, rest here twice. Yes, I will spare one of my bottles of whiskey for you. We're still not stealing their idol. I think that would be a bad idea. We don't need the points. If I walk to here, we'll be able to see what this is, and then be able to make a decision. I know this is not the most optimal. Ah, it's a climbing shrine. Shoot. Alright, well, we have a 50% chance of just rolling the man and making the climb. Even if we don't make the climb, there's still a chance that we survive, that whoever falls survives. Dumb as that sounds, there's a chance and there's a chance. I think that is our plan. I think that is literally the only plan we have available. Because we need two moonstones, so we have to hit two shrines. Alright, what do we drop? What do we drop? Torches? There's still a couple of caves. World creation returns tiles to their initial state, I believe. I wonder if using this will stop the chasm from expanding. I don't really have a lot of other uses for it, so let's try it. And then we still gotta drop something. That was not related to the dropping something. I mean, whatever, we're desert explorers, we'll be fine. Please stop, please stop, please stop. Okay, the chasm's still growing, but it's like getting dynamically overwritten by the world creation thing. It's super weird. This is gonna create more chasm. Alright. We didn't do it. Please nobody die. Please nobody die. Or at least not the animal handler. Okay, Sister Amelia... Oh, wow. Suffered a nasty head injury. That's fine. We'll make that work. Okay. Okay, so we need to drop two slots. Like, trade value is a thing that we don't really need anymore. I'm reticent to throw the horn flute away because the horn flute could actually make us not die, which is, I probably don't have to tell you, fairly large. It's kind of a big deal. How injured is she? She's very injured. Okay. But she has so little health that she might even heal. Okay, so we could drop the hyena pelts and the torches. We're not going to this. Yeah, alright. This is 60 trade value. I'd rather drop the dynamite. Yeah, we don't need dynamite. Alright. So now to get back up here, we need 98 sanity. That's a lot of alcohol. We might be able to swing by the shaman's hut again on our way out. Okay, so we have to run in a pretty straight line. The game's going to want to path us all funny, trying to min-max our sanity, and I appreciate what it's trying to do, but we can't do that right now. Alright, let's make it to here, and then we'll plan from there. Yeah, the world creation thing and the chasm thing are having a strange interaction right now. Well, that was super weird. The world creation scroll may be responsible for the fact that this mission is still in one piece, and I don't remember what we have in that mission's storeroom, but I bet it's not nothing. Alright. Enter the pyramid. Cool. We're getting no kind of timing bonus at all on this one. So, we could go south and head back that way. Right. Hit the village. Be able to stay at the village. Ooh, maybe. We have all these pelts. Then from there to the mission. Then from the mission home. Right. It's a long walk, and it's going to necessitate some camping out. The other path that we have available to us is through the north, but the northern path, as much as I would like to stay at the waterfall, is just too beset with enemies. I don't think it's safe. So am I allowed to camp right here? No, because we're inside the pyramid space. We have to get out of that. How much would it cost to just walk to the village? 95? Well, why don't we level up Sister Amelia? And then that would require us to use 2 whiskey. We've gotten pretty lucky. There's not been a lot of alcoholism. And I actually like the path it's drawing for us here because it takes us aside the mosquito cloud and then all the way over to the east to make it less likely that we have to deal with the bird. We do have 1 horn flute left, but I'd like to not have to use it right now. It'd be great if we could save it so that we have it if we get caught by something as we're heading east. Our aggro chance is low enough. I don't want to use the drums. Normally I would use the drums so that we can start their cooldown, but we're going to be taking a pretty long walk. Wow, 122. We ran out of water, man. We need more water. Alright, it's fine. We can actually get to 122. Alright, let's trade with them. We're at -4. So, at 70 per stay, this isn't too bad. We probably want to go up a couple of standing. Like maybe as high as +4? Yeah, let's do that. Rest twice, which will probably be pretty safe. We lose standing if we refuse. Ah, we gain some alcoholism. Not good. Alright, then we rest. Sleep. Leave. Okay. Pretty uneventful trip over to the mission. And then from there, we can go here, and then to the oasis. Yeah, we're doing okay without being able to hunt. We've gone through like 20 whiskey on this expedition alone. It's not a sustainable rate of expenditure. But you know, the game's almost over. We don't need sustainable all that badly. So how much room is in this? Okay, we can throw a couple more things in here. Alright, yeah, rest. Sure, at this point, whatever. Everybody's an alcoholic. Ooh. So the priest is gonna be gone. And for some reason, we can't stay here if the priest isn't here. Despite the fact that that's very silly. Alright, we don't actually have enough green mushrooms to be able to cleanse all the alcoholism. I definitely should not have drank that alcohol. Okay, well, oh, we're one slot over. Shoot. Well, whatever. Let's see if it does actually work the... Oops, no, that's not what I wanted. I wanted to click on this. Let's see if that does actually work the way I think it does. Wow. That's crazy. Do we have enough room for that? We do. We just barely have enough room for that. Okay. Oh, we can just make it back. We definitely want to go, like, north, though. Try to avoid the raptor. Okay. We came in fifth, but we did get a lot of loot. And, most importantly, we survived. Everybody survived, which is crazy. Okay, yeah, I'm sure we got last by, like, a really long time, too. Out of curiosity, 306 days. We were out here for almost a year. Alright, so what are we getting for our last expedition? Jeez, these are not great. I'm gonna take waterproof? These are really not great. Waterproof seems fine. The last prehistoric area is very swampy, so it will come into play. Sell, keep. I guess we should sell these. Yeah, let's be safe. I was really honestly considering gifting the tusks. And then we just gift all of this stuff. Yep, 2980. Pretty okay. All we have to do is not die. That's it. That's all we have to do. I'm pretty sure it said buried golden pyramid. I just realized it in the book. Nope, don't care about your stupid map. No thanks. Let's just buy all the whiskey and all the weather balloons and torches and machetes and ropes and whatever, man. Climbing gear? Cool. Deal. Alright, we are going to be okay. I'm going to, at the start of this expedition, we're going to launch, was it 7 or 8 weather balloons? I think 7. All we have to do is survive. To be perfectly honest, we could probably just turn around and leave, but I feel insecure without actually doing it. And also, that's not fun. Well, okay, that's some information. Honestly, if we get into like a dire situation, we have to weather balloon out of here, I think we still win. Let's try to at least find the pyramid. Not super happy with the amount of vision that we have so far. Alright, let's see what the trader has. Probably nothing of interest, because usually what he has is nothing of interest. Okay, that's fame. But he wants full price for him. Actually, we can do that. I'm pretty sure we have a buried golden pyramid, so... Yeah, I'll buy 60 fame, sure. Again, fame. We are at 2 standing. Why don't we just give them all of these, because I don't want to carry them anymore. And actually, let's buy the horn flutes. I like those. Yeah, deal. Rest once. I will not be eating your crazy human meat. I don't even know where they would get human meat. Maybe the last group of explorers. Alright, we have enough horn flutes that we don't have to be super careful. Let's see what this trader has. Okay. Actually, can we afford this? Not really. We can give him this. I haven't been using the campsite all that much. We could give him the campsite. Eh, you know what? We're fine. We're good. Thanks. Alright, come on, be an easy shrine. We do have ropes for climbing. We have a safe climb here. Alright. It's gonna start up some volcanoes. Okay, that's cool. Wow, it sure did. We need to get out of here, like, with the quickness. Straight away. Run, run, run. Oh my god, it's so much fire. That is... Oh, hey. We ran out of sanity. The fire doesn't render sometimes. You're in fire spaces, but the fire is invisible. I dislike that. Okay. There's no danger to using the whiskey at this point. Everybody in the crew is already an alcoholic. I would like to rest, please. You tell them you want to rest, and they don't even actually... They're not even actually cool with it? That's annoying. This does let us take their trade, though. So we beat the system, guys. Yeah. Could you rest again? I'll give you... 3 torches? Oh no, wait, you want one of these like terrible tome pages and 2 torches? How about that? Nah, I need these torches, right? These are important. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, we go back to full. They hate us now. This is potentially a waterfall? Okay, it is a cave. Yeah, sure. Let's go somewhere else. This place sucks. It took us not very far to the south. That's probably a stone circle. Not useful. That could be something. I'm really concerned that we can't fight a giant bird, but we could horn flute the bird. Yeah, let's go find out what this is. It is just a stone overhang. Damn it. You need to chill. Ah, this sucks. Is it just a stone circle? It's a raptor nest. That's likely to be even less good. Okay, these are real items. Things that I actually care about a little bit. A raptor egg would have been a total bummer. Let's go around this side. Go. Let's try to be far away from the fire. That's not very useful information. Man, we're having a tough one here. Ropes and a treasure map. And some hyenas. I'm obviously not too worried about the hyenas. What's this? Okay, there we go. There's the first seal. Unfortunately, no easy way to fight these hyenas. Let's head this way, I think. The hyenas can chase us. And if they catch us, we'll fight them or whatever. I don't particularly need to fight them. Alright, we may as well drink a bunch of whiskey now. There's no sense not filling up our sanity, right? Since there's no negative possibly associated with the whiskey at this moment. We're all alcoholics already. Alright. Seal 2. We might do this through dumb luck. Alright, there's no path through here. We can see that. I guess that's not necessarily true. There could be a path that goes like this. The far more likely path is this way, but obviously volcanoes. Yeah, whatever. I think we gotta risk it. If the volcanoes start going off, then we will suddenly make different plans. Provided that that's an option we have. Oh, cancel. No! Okay. It is two raptors. It's not inconceivable that we could kill two raptors. Actually, this one's dead. He's gonna bleed. So there's nothing I can do with green, blue, blue, right? Aside from try to roll shields. Oh, I can do this. I'll take one of his dice away. It did something. Alright, if we can just replicate that. We've done a terrible job. Okay, we've got our hands. Got our eyes. If this rerolls sword, we win. Okay. So, what we do have is Ripper Leap into Headbutt for a point of damage and removing a die, and then we have 2 points of shielding. Alright, we don't have to hit him for very much this turn. By the way, in case it was unclear, we got super lucky that this was two raptors and not three. That would have been really bad. Alright, well, the meat's certainly not very useful to us. We need to be north of here in a real hurry. What kind of shrine is this? Nope. That is a void shrine. I have no interest. I'm starting to think that this may not be where the last seal is. That could be a seal. We should try to get to this cave and see if it's a tunnel. We can't go back the way we came for a while. I could just wait. But I'm nervous about setting up the campsite because it could burn down around us. I don't want to get stuck in one place for multiple days. Let's just do a wait. Let's actually wait. Oh, this fire can't spread very far. The burned out area is ringing it. Yeah, never mind. We're being silly. Let's just... Should I make camp? You know what? Yeah. Okay. This is our final adventure together, that's true. You're a very deep person. Alright, let's... Yeah, we'll just rest to full. I think we'll be able to get through at that point. Ooh, actually, we're resting for kind of a long time. I noticed Sister Amelia observing me in ways that one would show desire. This is terrible. Is that how you show desire? I've been doing it wrong. Yeah, I'm starting to get nervous. I think we waited too long. Alright, let's try to get around to this cave. Nope. It is no longer the case that there is a ring of burned out tiles. The fire could spread northward. So we will watch it carefully. As carefully as we can without always being able to see where it is. We will now, at this juncture, back up. Okay, it burned out. I hate this, really stop-and-go travel. It's very bad for our sanity. Alright, let's just go deal with the hyenas. Alright, so we're looking for Oh, we didn't actually roll the thing we're looking for here. We need a mind to get our faint off. Okay. And then we have punctuation for one of them. And hey, look at that, we hard rolled the Ripper Leap. Keep a couple of minds and a couple of eyes, I like that. Looking for hands and swords. Uh-oh. Okay, I was gonna say, is this gonna be the first turn? Ooh. So we don't have... Oh, never mind. We have enough damage to actually kill them. Did that not deal damage? But what happened to my punctuation? Huh. Did I, like, not have a target selected? Is that a thing you can do, even? Weird. Alright, I will take the teeth. We don't have room for anything else. Is there anything in my inventory that I want less than this stuff? I don't think so. We don't need to interact with the villagers again. They wouldn't let us in to do it anyway. Actually, is that going to be an issue? Isn't the village... Yeah, the village is quite close to the boat. Hmm. Well. Nothing I can do about it right now. I want to see what's in this cave. We are running a little bit low on whiskey. Hey, we found some chocolate, though. Alright, it's also possible that there's, Oh, there's another village down here. It's also possible that there's a seal over in this area. I don't think it's too likely. Again, I'm just basing this on the way the game has seemed to unfold thus far in previous plays. But over here, maybe? This is going to be the plan. We can go to this overhang. We're going to be pursued by villagers. Faint is pretty effective against villagers, though. They only have two dice each, and they generally don't have, like, red dice. They have to combo their dice in order to get any damage out. So maybe we don't have to be too afraid of the villagers. This party might actually be okay at fighting villagers. Giant bird, you monster, go away. Okay, no, we're fine, we're fine. Our pacifist nature has convinced the bird that he does not need to mess with me. Somehow. I don't truly understand the workings of that. Do I want to... It would cost me a whiskey... Or no, it would cost me an upgrade. Aha! To get out of Low Sanity Town. Seems like a fine time to use it. Sure, I will accept your quest. I'm not going to do it, but I'm concerned that if I told them no, they would be, you know, mad. That's not awesome. Oh boy, we're going to have to deal with a lot of villagers. Okay, so you can see actually quite a lot of red dice. Everybody's got to make me look like an idiot, right? This is important to them. Okay, we do want to try to roll faint. Okay, so there's the mind. And we really need to roll some good stuff here, okay. We get a lot of damage onto that guy. Alright, so this is his only turn. He bleeds out at the beginning of the next turn. Wow, we rolled Faint plus Ripper Leap right off the top here. Right. Reduce their numbers as much as possible. Let's headbutt this guy. He gets no dice. And then let the bleeding happen. Damn it, they still managed to roll some damage. Alright, this guy needs a little bit more of a push. So I don't think we will faint this time. I do want to use that red die for punctuation if possible. So let's keep all of these. We have to get a little bit more damage onto him. Yeah, this is kind of rough. Uh-oh. Okay. We did not roll very much damage here. We can throw out a punctuation to kill one of them. And then, like, remove one of his dice and take 2 points of shield. Okay, that's something. This is definitely not the most powerful combat party we've ever had. Okay, that's lethal. Anything cool? Not really. I'm pretty sure that I can use the red mushrooms on myself without any chance of anything bad happening. Okay, Bedipur started a fire. That's not awesome. Let's just drink the last of the whiskey and move. Turns out we are not going to sleep here. Alright, that could be the pyramid. Just based on the shape of everything, it is. Okay. Is the remaining seal in the top right? It is. It's exactly where I thought it was. Look at... I'm getting so good at figuring out how the map gen goes. Alright, not great, this. What are we going to do? We're going to use this. That's... Alright. It just replaced one campsite with a different campsite. Yeah, the, wow. The non-stop cavalcade of villagers is going to be a serious issue. Right, we should be able to move to here safely. Okay, they chose to only move forward one space. Obviously, I'm trying to avoid them getting adjacent to us suddenly. Because I want to initiate the attack. Yeah, we can do this. This is the same fight, but more so? Yeah, that sucks. Alright. Show me damage. Show me damage. Wow, you suck. Okay. We got 2 damage. Is that right? Is that that's the only thing we can do? Is this? Technically, I guess we should remove the lizard shaman first. He's the weakest, so we remove more dice that way. And he can heal the others, which could drag the battle out unnecessarily. Okay, they managed to roll nothing because faint is very powerful against enemies who have not a lot of dice. We're doing a terrible job of rolling the things we need. Okay, come on. Oh no, no more rolls left, actually. Well, we do have second feint. They don't get to do anything. Please, for the love of... Just show me some swords, man. So we'd actually like this to come up eye, right? We only need one mind. Okay, I like all of this stuff. So we have punctuation, we have feint, okay. The feint's non-negotiable, I think. Oops, I don't know, I'm putting back dice for feint after saying that. Then we have punctuation. So we could finish off the lizard shaman, but maybe it's more important to get this really heavy bleed onto somebody else. And then we have that. Alright. Damn it, of course he got healed. Alright, well, it doesn't take very much damage to push this guy back to lethal. So we'll do a feint. We have to hit him for 2. What we really want to do is get mind, hand, sword, eye. Yeah. So we're looking for eye. Okay. So sword eye is a kill on this guy. And then if we can roll hand here, we can get I can get another feint, whatever. Yeah, the fact that we can actually fairly frequently roll double feint makes these enemies a lot less scary. I didn't really realize that was going to be a capability. So all these dice are wrong. Sorry, that one's fine. Whatever. Take the safe path. Seriously, though, let's get rid of that guy. Yeah, sorry this probably isn't that exciting to watch, but it's really effective. It makes it hard not to do it. Okay, I would have been cool. So I guess we're outsmarting them, right? There's no hope for them to defeat us because we're outmaneuvering them to such a degree. Well, let's save all these dice and that. Okay, ideally we would have hand, eye, so that's a feint, plus a punctuation. Yeah, so let's use the feint. We're leaving our zone of perfect safety here. But we don't have to. We can do a precise attack here, and then try to roll into... Yeah, we could have rolled another feint. But we definitely want to get a kill. Okay. They got a spear attack off, a single spear attack. It's not a big deal. They did generate a little bit of shielding. That's annoying. I love eyes. Come on, show me hands. Okay. So we generated just enough hands for a single feint. I would obviously much rather have had a Ripper Leap. Okay, we get some serious damage onto that guy. Man, the fact that they get infinite spear dice is pretty cool. That's powerful. Okay, excellent. Do I want to... Nah. I was going to say, do I want to just go for another feint, but no, I don't. I want to go for ending this damn combat. That's what I want to do. Alright, just you and me, man. So this is not terribly great. If we can roll Ripper Leap plus punctuation, we can just kill him. Show me hand. Damn it. Okay, so we have this, and then nothing else. And he has both of his dice. But I guess the best he could generate is kick, so any turn that we can do three shields, he can't do anything about it. Alright, there we go, that's a kill. Hey, mangoes. And, I mean, again, there's no reason to throw away the red mushroom when we can take it ourselves. Using it on our allies is a definitely sketchy strategy, but we don't need these. Sorry, I guess we do actually have a map? Yeah, I'm not going to bother trying to do that. Alright, we just need to stop earlier than I think we do, but not so much earlier that we don't even get to attack. Okay. Damn it. Are you kidding me? Five, six of them. We might have to just bail. Alright. Okay. Not great. We're definitely... six of them. Okay. So we're hunting for double feint. We need double feint to be alive. And then honestly, we can't deal meaningful damage to them this turn. Yeah. So we just double feint every turn, and then they won't have shielding from now on, so we slowly kill them. Do I want to try to hold man for... I would need to roll double hand for man to be useful, whereas I just need to roll eye for sword to be useful. Okay, so we do feint, and then we do precise attack on... yeah. Guy with the lowest health. Killing them is our only way out here. Okay. Not a great start. Okay, that was pretty good though. Alright, yeah, we gotta get out of here, man. We gotta finish this adventure. How long is she poisoned for? Another 4 turns, so she won't die. Okay, oops, I put back an eye. Keep sword. Okay, pretty bad. Not ideal. We can generate a lot of shielding for ourselves, but they have quite a few dice left. Yeah, and the healing is a problem. Okay, we need these. Uh-oh. Okay, well the good news is we have punctuation this turn. So that'll kill this guy. No more healing. And now it's just a battle of attrition, which in theory we should win. With them not being able to generate any more healing. They can still generate shields. Alright, I'll take a kick. 1 point of damage on somebody. Yeah, this sucks. We gotta get out of here quickly. Uh-oh. Yep. Pretty bad. Okay, so we do precise attack on him and 3 points of shielding and... ah, they have so many dice. Oh, wow. Okay, we got away without getting hit there. Are you kidding me? Okay, well that's double feint. It's not a lot of damage. But like, not losing the game is our primary goal right now. Because I am not going to lose a huge run to the fact that we generated a crazy amount of disapproval at the very end of the game. That would be embarrassing. Maybe I am going to lose that way. Okay, we're doing alright. We're doing alright. Everything's going to be fine. So that guy's going to be dead next time we can get a solid hit on him. Once we have them down below a certain number of dice, it becomes much easier to survive a turn where we don't get the double feint. Alright, so now we have to make a decision. Do I want to go for the feint, or do I want to just take this eye? Right, we can hold this eye and roll and still get our feint. Do I want to take this eye for punctuation? No, I want to play safe. Okay. And we got there. 3 left. Right. Each time we kill one of them, it gets so much more likely that we will whiff a feint and not take any additional damage. Right, come on, show me mind. Got there. Very slowly whittle them down. So the red guys on the spears, I think it is still better to eliminate the 10 health target, because man spear doesn't do anything and spear doesn't do anything. So even if we kill this guy off, they still have to get a pretty specific result in order to deal damage to us through a single feint. We want to hold this. Show me that hand. Alright. We only get 1 damage this turn. Ugh. All right, there it is already. Right, we need to get one more precise attack or kick. It could turn out to be a kick. Uh-oh. This is looking bad. Okay, we got a pretty weak attack out of this turn. Alright, but now we can kill him with sword plus shield if we need to. And okay, we need mind eye. I'm not gonna pick up the second mind yet. Okay, we got there. And faint, and we need eye or shield for the kill. Did not make it. Oh, this is agonizing. Okay, happy with those. Actually, these are all good. Okay. So wait, we can just do this. Yeah. There's no reason to spend the extra dice. Alright, and now a turn where we whiff the second feint is much less likely to yield any damage. That said, we're still going to go for it, because I'm not crazy. Once we have him down to just one, we can change strategies completely. It won't matter anymore. Okay, we would rather have the 3 damage, obviously. Yeah, if we can just get a single stun onto them when they're just one, it will prevent them from being able to deal more than 1 point of damage, which is all we... We can totally stand 1 point a couple of times. Show me eye. Awesome. Alright, we just need that to happen one more time. Okay. Yeah, so like I said, now the fight's pretty different. Now we're looking for Ripper Leaps. Can accelerate things a little bit. Wow, real bad. Okay, a point of damage. Totally something we can deal with. He has 12 health. So we have 7 points of... Yeah, actually, this is lethal. There we go. Jesus. There's no reason not to take these, and we won't take the spear. We already have a spear. Why am I carrying a spear around? Okay, yeah, this sucks, man. All this fighting sucks. Should I just weather balloon this? Yeah, you know what? Screw this. Ready the balloon. We shall bring with us 100 fame worth of tusks and 40 fame worth of raptor skins. Whatever, we're fine. We win. We win by a mile. I really wanted to get that golden pyramid, but at a certain point, it just... The thing is, we totally would have done it. The villagers could never kill us. Well, maybe not never. But, man, the tedium of it. Mary Kingsley returned to the heart of the Empire, London, in triumph. Once the statue was modeled on her likeness, she enjoyed a happy life and the knowledge that history would hold her as the best the club had to offer. Badipur returned to his homeland and did not set foot into the Western world again. He never spoke another word about what he had seen during his travels. During his late life, he became obsessed with haunting dreams about a forgotten 7th expedition. He disappeared without any trace. This is a shitty thing to do, by the way. Developers, trying to trick us into obsessing ourselves about a 7th expedition. I'm exactly the kind of person who falls for this stuff, too. Shapuji Babha returned home and became a consultant at the British Museum. He was plagued by endless nightmares about the horrific things he had seen. During his late life, he became obsessed with haunting dreams about a remaining mysterious pyramid, and disappeared without any trace. At least he had good company. Sister Amelia returned to her home and lived a secluded life. After some years, she released her memoirs, which became an overnight success and made her the talk of the society. She named her first child after the name of the ship that brought her home. I don't think we've seen that line before. She lived a quiet life and died in the presence of her order. Alright, well, things are getting a little unconventional, but we're starting to be able to win with a broader range of strategies. And, we're almost done. Two more remain. I think Marie Curie will probably be a total blowout. She starts with a great party and a really strong starting perk. And Marcus Garvey will at least be exciting. Come back next time for one of those things. And we'll see you then.